Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Painkiller, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. As per usual, we are just jumping on in here, and today we are tackling the military base. If this is the level I think it is, there's, you know, possibility for me to get irrevocably lost, although I think I have a vague idea of where we're supposed to go, if this is the level, like I said. Lots of ifs. You know, it's also if I can survive getting through this room. All right. Oh, nice try, buddy. Oh, shit. Ha, wall cover. Oh, exploding barrels. All right. This might be slightly challenging. I don't know how much I approve. I'm gonna blow that up first, because I think that's what killed me. Alright. Let's employ. Okay, so no, that exploding killed me. That's actually gonna make this substantially more challenging. Alright. Well, I'm gonna kill you first. Tentatively. There we go. Ah, I missed him. I'm gonna kill this guy. Alright. Look at that. Having to use tactics and stuff. I don't approve. I'm also incredibly injured. Don't think I don't see you hiding back there, ammo crate. Freaking. Stairwells like this are just murder holes. If Arma has taught me anything, it's that stairwells like this are just terrible. Because, like, especially in Arma, because you get shot once and you die. But it's one of those things where, like, there's no way to really safely go up. Seriously, guys, come on now. Oh, 11 hit points. I've been in far worse situations. Also, I see that there's health over here. All right. Get him. Missed. That one didn't. All right. This is the area that I'm thinking of, by the way. Or the map that I'm thinking of. Bunch of explosives. I'm okay with. Nothing else over there. Random pictures. Planes. Just checking to see if there's any, like, movie references or anything. Alright, now, if I recall correctly, there's the exit to this chunk of area. Like, none of these gates open. There's something in this area. Like, in this building. But naturally, we're gonna be getting attacked. And these guys, no, where's my damn rocket launcher? There it is. These guys have glowing masks, which signifies probably, if I had to guess, more health. But I don't know for sure. Oh god, my hit points. I still die to stray rocket fire, and that's all that matters to me. All right, one more dude. Okay, grab all the souls we can here. I think there's one chasing me. Yeah. All right. Good joke. Is that everybody? Is that everybody? I think that's everybody. Oh, we also have a little ammo bunker. I'll take that. Need some more chain gun ammo. Let's see what we got here. We'll see how long it takes me to figure this out. I mean, we could probably jump up those. Oh, is it right through here? Is this what I'm looking for? No. Excuse me. I'm gonna quick save just in case I kill myself. Look at that. Esports. It's just a secret. But I'm gonna say we just jumped the fence? No. Oh. See, this is it. I could have sworn that there was something in there, but apparently not. And this has been, like, every time I have played this game, because we have to do something to open this gate. Shame we can't get into the rifles. But you'd think, you know, we just come over here and there's, like, a button. But there's no buttons in this game. This game is about violence and mayhem. Is it perhaps back here? Some electric ammo on a way up, which I doubt we can get up there. Right out there, yeah, they're not gonna let us. Let's see here. That's shut. All right, nothing there. Apparently I just did that, which opened it. All right. I have no idea how I managed to do that, but I'll take it. I have no idea what triggered that. One quick save again. But like I said, I will take it. That was a trap. That was a trap, oh my god, they're everywhere. All right, that wasn't too bad. Naturally, I wanna see what's back here. Armor I will take. We're looking okay, I think. I don't know how this game handles armor with regards to health. I know you take health damage in addition to armor damage, but I don't think it's like all the time, but it's not in like, say, Doom 2016, where they chew through all of your armor before they start working down your health. Like you can see there that we were at, you know, 150 armor and 40 and change health, and now we're at 30 health. So, like I said, I don't know what the exact numbers are, but I think it's the better way to do it. Like in Doom 2016, that was, I guess, one of the things about that game that kind of disappointed me is that armor was just essentially like a second health pool. And previous to that, like even in Doom 3, that's not how armor worked. Seriously, nothing up here? Nothing. Can't even jump on the fence. Ah, disappointing. But that's really, like, I don't know. It's something that is mechanically different. And, you know, when you're making a game, it's kind of part of a series. That's something that personally I would want to avoid, like changing mechanics like that. But it's not something that I'm gonna be like, this game's terrible. Like it's not enough of a black mark against the game to where I'm gonna, you know, decry the developers for making that development choice. It's not like, say, Doom 3. That entire game is just a poor develop. Now I can't say that, cause like Doom 3, the Lost Mission, you know, I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. I actually enjoyed my playthrough of that. I mean, there was a little bit of the Doom bullshit in there, but overall, it was mostly focused on, like, you know, just kind of run and gun, and that's what I want when I play Doom, and so, you know, I enjoyed it. And I think we go that way. But I don't know. I'm not gonna... I wouldn't say that I find myself softening in my old age. I still do not like Doom 3. I do not think Doom 3 is a good Doom game at all. Alright, so what do I have to... Oh, alright. I don't think Doom 3 is a good Doom game at all, but The Lost Mission is not a bad shooter. Alright, so what's going on? What do you guys do? Ah, bullshit! All right. And that is why I am saving the, That's why I'm saving these freeze rounds, because they're really good for taking out enemies that are otherwise a little more durable than they need to be. Get out of here! Get out of here! What is this? This is just wrong. Alright. Trying to avoid getting stuck in a corner, but it ended up saving me. I don't know. Mechanically, I like when... Oh my god. I don't want to be backing up either because of this jerk. I like it better when armor isn't just an extra health pool, because it means you have to monitor both. Like, armor... Like, I'd be okay with armor even, like, absorbing, like, say, 80 or 90% of all damage you take, but you still take health damage, because then you can't play stupidly. You can play a little bit more recklessly, because armor's going to absorb the majority of the damage. I bet you there's something... Oh, yeah, I think I see some armor up there. Damn it. I'm sure we could have probably used barrels to get up there. Use these things, maybe. Let's see if I can... make do here. I'm doubtful, but you never know. Essentially, what I need to do is take this and get it vertical. So can I just, like... If I could, like, smush it up against the wall just right, I feel as though I can... do what I need to do here. All right. No. Stay. Okay. All right. Look at that. No. Oh, I almost had it. I hate everything. Look at that though. See, I know what I'm doing. I've learned this game's physics system. It's like kind of like using the force. You just get it after a while. The midichlorians become dense enough in your bloodstream that you essentially become the one and can get the armor that the developers have cleverly hidden on the wall to taunt you with. God damn it, quit moving back and forth, you stupid thing. Oh my god. All right. Quick save is what I do. I did it. I did it the first time and now the game's like, yeah, that's all you're getting, you dick. Come on. Damn it! Whatever. I'm not gonna spend 20 minutes trying to properly align that thing. It's just not worth it. So we're in a missile silo. If you had not realized. Is this where we... Yeah, that's where we came from. Okay. Can I shoot it? Yes, I can. Okay, these goodies up there. Are we supposed to just drop? Apparently so. Okay, so there's another exit. And the way down looks to be probable death. Let's find out. Oh, no! Oh, okay. All right. Is this... Like, I'm not gonna try for it. Damn right, secret area discovered. Oh, shit! Okay, let's not. That's nasty. Throwing all kinds of horribleness at me as soon as I come out of the secret. Is that everybody? I think that's everybody. Ah, oh, we're at 65. We are prepping for Demon Bringer here. All right, so where am I? Okay, I got you. Oh man, I'm almost out of freeze rays and I just keep just all right. So I just keep squandering them. Oh hey, there's that armor that I, you know, was fighting with. Nice. How'd that work out for you, buddy? All right. Where am I supposed to go? Here's the top. I might have missed a guy below. Did I? I think this is where I came in. Okay, there's this. Let's see, there was. Okay. So I assume then I'm supposed to go this way because there was an alternate path. They appear to have all sealed? Yes. Alright. Back down the hole. and we'll come back up the secret again. And I want to say next episode's a boss fight, if I recall correctly. I think Act 3 only has 4 levels, and one of those is the boss fight. Like, this game, overall, isn't too terribly long. I felt that the expansion, like, felt longer than it was. The expansion, I'm gonna say it, is not as good as the base game. It's not bad, but it's not as good as this. Oh, we can't actually blow these up. Good to know. Hey. Still, there we go. Alright, I assume that I'm supposed to get up to the top of the rocket. So, that is my goal. Grab that. Yeah. Okay. So they're giving us some explosives. And this is probably the end? I honestly don't remember. Oh, yeah. Let's, can I get around this? Maybe? I can. Look at that. No real point in doing so. I think you can kill these things. I don't recall entirely, though. So am I, like, safe right here? I think I am. I wonder if I could just... I wonder if I can just lob a grenade up around this, but... Well, apparently not. Let's see, do we have... Yeah, we have rockets. That'll make this easy. Get up there. Because you want to, the goal is to hit that dude in the back there and, you know, not get hit by the massive ass cannon. That's a hyphenated, by the way, for you XKCD readers out there thinking about moving that comma around. All right, where's that? If I recall correctly, yeah, I think there's another one of them right there. There are more than one of these things. Is that out of range? Yeah. Hell. Can I do my sniper rifle? Wrong button. I don't know if this will actually work. I don't think so. Doesn't look like it. No? I tried. Okay. We have rockets. Also trash mobs, apparently. Alright, these guys, these are my primary targets right here. Okay, you can destroy those just by shooting them with explosives. I don't believe shooting them with just small arms will do too much to them. Oh, we have a tank! Wunderbar! Alright. Alright, where's that tank at? Just trolling around, probably out of range. Yes, alright. That's fine. I am pretty confident in my ability to circle straight, yeah. With my jump, with my bunny hops, I'm pretty good with regards to being able to avoid projectiles that aren't bullets from those obnoxious little dudes. Okay, well, there's obvious goodies on the plane. That was a trap! Ooh. Well, now, you guys gotta screw off for a minute. There's probably goodies up there. Maybe not. I don't know. I can't tell, it doesn't look like there's enough room to move up there, but there might be. And that's enough to make me wonder. Especially with that little ladder dangling there. Yeah. What? Bounty! Oh, come on now. Get up there. This box. Like, I like that this game has physics on stuff, but the problem is that, like, nothing feels like it has weight. Like, everything is just really slidey, as you guys are seeing here. There we go. All right. Look at that. Mega health. I'll take it. Some armor. A shedload of bullets. Nice. Anything else? No, no. All right. I'll take it. Nice. I'm gonna quick save. Look at that. 160 health, 200 armor. Feeling pretty good. You guys gonna move out of, yeah, I was gonna say, you guys gonna move out of tank, are ya? You dicks? Last one was what, 5 rockets? Yep. Alright, if I had to guess, I'd say, but there's another one! And there was. Alright. You gonna go for any more? It does not look like it, based on the doors floating around. That's right, get all clumped up for me. Here, where is it? Shitload of ammo for this. You guys see how this thing works. As you can see, like, it just destroys things that get near it. Although, I guess helps that these things are pretty, pretty wimpy. Alright, we've got a crap load of ammo for our shuriken cannon here, so that's probably what I'm gonna use for a little bit. See, I know we're supposed to go that way, but I just wanna stick my nose back here, see if there's anything in there. It's not. Poke around back here. Nothing. All right. Again, just, you know, making sure. I'm not exactly going for completion or anything, but still, it's nice to. God, I hate you dudes. Freaking obnoxious ass. Gotta hit him in a certain place to kill him. Oh, you guys are dead. That sure cannon shock mine will just mow these dudes down. The shuriken's actually a pretty good weapon. I don't mind it. I obviously prefer, like, the rocket launcher and stuff to it. But it's pretty decent. I would say probably use it over the shotgun in a lot of cases. Oh my god, you dudes are just, you know, worst! It's the hordes! Lord. Okay, I figure I'm supposed to go up top, but as per usual, I'm gonna poke around, and for doing so, we got some stakes. I'll take it. Crap. Ah. Alright, I need to hit you with this so that I can easily kill you. It's hard to like, nail those guys where I have to shoot them when you've got, like, very limited area to move, and that's where the ability to just insta-give them with the freeze from the shotgun kind of comes in. All right, where are we going? We're going up. Uh-huh, that's what I was waiting for. Freaking stick one of you jerkwads in here. All right, I think this maybe moves the plane. I don't remember. I think there's, like, some set piece here. Maybe not. Could have sworn I remembered, like, a plane plowing into a building or something. We are apparently going this way. Anything on the roof? No. Man, I would have hit something back here, like maybe a couple ammo boxes, nothing crazy. Ooh. Alright, here we go. I was gonna say, is there a way for me to get off of here without sustaining fall damage? All right. I see you down there. Don't think I don't. Little ammo box trying to hide. Chain gun ammo, no less. Valuable commodity. Nothing. 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 Ah. This is why you gotta poke around everywhere. All right, so according to yielding compass, there's something this way. Which. See, and it's like up here. Like, I can see it over there. Oh my gosh. I don't know, guys. The compass lies. Unless it's pointing towards something else, which is, you know, possible. Alright. What do we got? Tank. All right, I want to test something on these tanks. Oh, actually, here, we'll test it here, too. I just cranked up my shot speed. Okay, so we can actually kill these things with small arms. Can we kill these with small arms? We can. I did not know that. Are you five shots too? Holy crap. Yay. Yes, I knew this was coming. That is specifically why. Oh no, we're out. I think it's dead, I think. Random hiccup striking in the middle of the sentence. Oh wow. Alright, let's go ahead and mow this. Look at it! Beautiful, and you can chain them on each other. It's just, it's glorious. It chewed up all of our ammo, but I don't even care. Because it also chewed up all of them, and now I'm going to chew up the rest. Oh, it's a thing of beauty. It's mowing everything down. And that is why you hold on to shuriken ammo. And one of the primary reasons I don't use it is so that I can keep stuff like that on hand. Alright. These guys, really, the only reason I freeze these dudes is because they're mostly just obnoxious. Like, these feel like enemies that should not take as much damage as they do. I don't know. Like, explosives. Stakes out, we're sealed in. I don't know. Like, the stake gun, it just doesn't feel as satisfying when you're not, like, nailing things to walls with it. Oh my lord. Where'd you come from, buddy? Chill out. It's just a prank, bro. You need to chill. Okay. Still trying to think of, like, good cold puns, and they're just not coming. Like, I got nothing. Alright, is that everything? That is everything. Okay. Also, kind of off topic, in a fit of irony showing that it's like the best thing in the world, I spent all of last episode talking about how I had yet to be hit by YouTube's adpocalypse monetization stuff, and I woke up today and hey, guess what guys, got a bunch of videos flagged as inappropriate for advertisers. A lot of actually, like, I would say, I think I'm, before this recording, I think it was at 13 episodes, I think this is episode 14 of Painkiller. I had like maybe 8 of the 13 episodes flagged as, you know, inappropriate for monetization. And like it's fascinating that, you know, I was just talking about it and now I get dinged with it. I don't know. The irony, I think, is a thing of beauty. Alright, I'm missing somebody and I don't know where they are. That or there's an exit that's open that I'm not realizing, which is probably just as likely. Like, can I get out of here now? Am I good? No. Alright. Do I have to jump the fence? Is that what is expected of me? I can't tell. Do I have to shoot this to open the way out? No. Okay. But yeah, so that happened. And like, I guess the thing that gets me about it is that, like, I would be willing to work. Like, I'm totally, like, I know a lot of people are like, well, you know, we should be able to monetize anything on YouTube. I don't necessarily agree with that at all. It is a closed garden, and, you know, what they say you can monetize is, you know, that's what you're allowed to monetize. The problem that I have with it, yeah, we can't even get out here. Damn. The problem that, oh, I see that guy over there. The problem that I have with it is, is that YouTube doesn't tell you what the issue is. They're just like, yeah, we've just blocked monetization on, you know, 30 of your videos just cuz, LOL. And that's essentially it. All right, so that, I think, is everything? Can we leave now? No. Well, this is... the music is dying. What's the trick? I apparently probably have to do something. I have to shoot that? No. What do, game? What do? Can't use my cards. Shooting it does nothing. What am I supposed to shoot? What do I shot? Do I shoot this? No. And like I said, I think the biggest thing for me is that, like, I just don't know what they want. Cause, like, if I could, you know, oh, seriously? Seriously, game, why? Like, if I could work with them, you know, to avoid posting content that they don't want, you know, I would do so. Within reason, obviously. But they don't tell you anything. They're just like, yeah, your video's monetized, demonetized, and... Oh, there we go. And they'll say, you know, like, you can look at the guidelines, and there's like 40 things. Well, it's probably closer to like 15 things. To, be not hyperbolic. Hyperbolic, I think, is the proper pronunciation of that. Anyways, and it's like, you guys, like, just tell me which one is the issue here. And if it's like, well, your videos have violent stuff in them, well, tough shit, that's, like, there's nothing I'm gonna do about that. Your videos have crude language in them, same deal, tough shit, there's nothing I'm gonna do about that. But, you know, if it's, you know, just their algorithm being top garbage, then, you know, there's a problem here. And they're like, well, they give you a thing on there that says, you know, what can I do about this? And they say, you know, you can appeal this video and they'll have someone take a look at it. What they don't tell you is when you go to appeal, that to appeal, your video has to have gotten 1,000 views in the last week. And so it's like, so you're basically screwing anyone who isn't a large channel. Like, anyone with, I would say to get 10,000 videos on, like, every 7 days, that isn't, like, you know, a channel that's doing nothing but miraculously making, you know, incredibly popular stuff, you would need somewhere in the vein of, I don't know, probably about 20,000 subs, maybe more. I would actually say probably more than that, because, like, Kikoski, he's got, I think he just hit 50,000, and he gets, I want to say he gets about 1,000 views on his videos within a week, generally. And it's like, you know, so the people that are going to get hit by this, like, I guess in part are the ones that are not going to be as horribly affected by it, because, like, you know, I've got, I just hit 2K subs, so it's not like, you know, I'm making bank off of this or anything, and I'm not in it to make bank, obviously, so, like, this whole, like, don't take this for me ranting as, like, a they took my gerb type thing. It's not that at all. My livelihood is completely unaffected by this. But, like, they're, you know, constantly saying, oh yeah, we're doing stuff to improve the experience for creators, and then they do something like this, where, like, they're essentially screwing anyone that isn't their biggest creators, and, you know, I understand, you know, YouTube's in it to make money, yada yada yada, but, like, this is just, like, this is just asshole design, essentially, and it's just trashy, and they should feel bad, but they don't, because it's YouTube. Oh my god, is it a tank? No. I don't. Oh. Alright. I was like, that thing just exploded, this massive thing. I was just like, no, it's just one guy. Alright. That was some damage. That is some trouble. Alright, I do have enough for one of these, but I think I'm gonna probably lean on the rocket launcher a little bit here. So yeah, like, I guess that's, like, my biggest problem with YouTube, like, in general, is that they literally... I shouldn't say literally, that's horrible. They generally, when they make these massive sweeping changes, they are just completely unreachable in any way unless you're, like, you know, PewDiePie or something. And it's just, It's very disheartening, and like I see people online, you know, asking, you know, should I, you know, get into Let's Playing and stuff, and it's like, yeah, but you need to realize that it's essentially a game that is rigged against you at this point. And like I would almost say that it was rigged against me as well, and I started back in like 2009. Let's Playing was just kind of, I wouldn't say just starting to get big, but since then it has only grown, and you know, the competition you're going up against is just crazy, which isn't to say you can't make it, of course. I mean, there are people with YouTube channels, you know, 5 years younger than mine that have 10 times the subscribers and stuff, and like, good for them. But what you need to do, like, you just need to understand that if you're gonna get into this, that like, that is far and away the exception, not the norm. And like, a lot of people, it seems like, a lot of people get into Let's Playing hoping it's gonna be like, you know, this easy road to stardom and, you know, all this fan base and stuff, and it's like, it does not work like that. Even if you are out there selling yourself, you know, it does not work like that. It is not easy. All right, so how can I best cheat my way through this? Oh, I wonder. This might work. Oh, wrong button. Are these, well, I mean, they work. It's not as, oh, there's what we need to do. All right, we just need to bounce them under the front of the thing. Okay. All right, that wasn't bad at all. But like, that's the thing is, like, if you want to get into Let's Play, cool, good for you. Buy a decent not shit mic, learn how to balance your audio, and you're gonna be better than probably 90% of the Let's Players out there. Like, that's all you need. And I guess have good, you know, passable video quality. I'm not even gonna say good video quality, passable video quality. But the thing is that even with that, it's a UFO! Even with that, you know, there is no guarantee that you're ever gonna even peak 100 subscribers. And you know, if you're just doing it as a hobby, cool. You know, I think, like, I would recommend this as a hobby to anyone who is afraid of, like, public speaking or anything like that. Socially awkward, I would recommend it, because it kind of teaches you to talk. And that's something that a lot of people actually have trouble with. Because, you know, just keeping a running commentary going, it's a talent. And it can be challenging at times, and it teaches you to kind of be more sure of yourself. And, you know, it teaches you, and depending on like what kind of person, it can teach you how to like make fun of yourself. It will certainly teach you how to grow a thicker skin, because if you do anything wrong in any game, there's going to be somebody that tells you about it, which, you know, is not necessarily a bad thing, but there will be people that tell you about it in a very dickish way, and that I've seen tends to be kind of make or break a lot with people, where they'll get like a bad comment and it just throws them into the dumps, and it's like, come on, guys, it's just somebody on the internet being a dick. Like, they're why do you care? My secret game, and don't think I didn't hear that exit pop up there, making sure. But yeah, so like that's YouTube being YouTube. You just need to come in understanding that the system is essentially against you on all fronts. And you're gonna need to be really lucky if you wanna make a living out of this. But if you come into it just looking to have a good time, it is probably the most rewarding hobby I have ever partaken in. Anyways, we done. I missed monsters. I think that's a first. Wow. I don't even know. Kill all monsters, you dicks. Man, I missed what, 14 enemies? Ah, disappointment. Anyways, I'm gonna call it here, and next time, ruins. Until then.